I think I have an illness. Over my extended weekend, due to the Thanksgiving holiday and some tragic time off, I heavily delved into Dragon Age Inquisition. I'll say I'm about 30 hours into the single player, but what surprised me is that I've put far more hours into the multiplayer. I can't describe this phenomenon. I just play it. I'll sit on the couch, turn on DAI, make the conscious decision to load up the multiplayer, and then ponder where the last 4 hours went. Did my roommates leave? Were they ever there? What day is it?
What year is it?
It's all a blur, but at some point, my Templar reached level 14 and looks different than before. Wasn't she level 18 earlier today? Also, there's definitely electricity coming from her mace. What did I do? Your life is rough when deciding to go a more melee route or poison route for your alchemist. It's the hardest decision you can make all day. Level 1 Arcane Warrior, you want to join my threatening game? Well, here we go, I guess. This is the person I've become, don't judge me. The question that repeatedly haunts me is, just how many times can you run these 5-stage dungeons? The thing about that question is, I don't have an answer. Sure, it's a fun concept to ponder between matches, but when the game starts, it's on. It's so on. Sure, there are 3 maps, 3 opponent types, and 3 difficulties, but aren't you essentially just doing the same damn thing over and over again with a different party makeup? What's the goal? To collect better gear and gain levels to take on harder difficulties? This sounds like a giant grind. Isn't that essentially simple and flawed? No, it isn't. While that formula may sound suspicious on paper, there's crazy factors that come into it that make you want to keep coming back. Fun. This is how other games like Diablo 3 and League of Legends essentially function. For the most part, LoL is the same map every single game, but your team and the opponent's team is different. Thus, you're playing a different role and always using a different strategy. While Dragon Age Inquisition isn't ever PvP, the different opponents add variety, especially the demons, and the different difficulties add layers of strategies. Especially the demons. With 9 playable characters, the diversity and makeup of your 4-man squad keeps the gameplay fresh. If you've just played 3 hours as a Legionnaire, you get burned out on tanking, why not switch to a Necromancer and crowd control the crap out of the enemies? Not only is the gameplay from Warrior, Rogue, and Mage different, but even the different subclasses feel completely different. Since you have the option to build these characters how you want, 2 Reavers could play completely different from one another. The class-specific doors that can be opened in matches push players to diversitize groups to maximize their efficiency. Like any dungeon crawler or even MMO, the ultimate goal is to get better gear to take on the hardest difficulty. The 3 difficulties wield different experiences and gold rewards. Thus, you are rewarded for completing more difficult tasks. Due to the randomly generated rewards found in chests, though, you don't have any sort of control of what weapons you receive. I've only ever received 2 purple weapons, and they've both been archer-specific bows. While I don't have to play an archer, the RNG elements make this class far more enticing than others, especially if I want to attempt to tackle the harder difficulties. What you can't control is what classes you unlock and crafting better armor for said classes. Any item you receive can be disassembled for raw material, which can be used for upgrades and to unlock other classes. Sure, the RNG gods can grant you new classes, but that isn't something you can rely on. The struggle is finding a class in each category you really enjoy, so you can have 1 of each for when the situation calls for it. If you join a game and you're the 4th person and your team doesn't have a mage, don't be that guy. Switch to a mage class. Since items are generally granted through bought chests outside of matches, who you play in a match only gets you experience for that class, so playing diverse characters doesn't hurt you in the least. While the pickup game system is really simple and fast, playing with friends is always a blast. Did that rhyme? Is there a better feeling than tanking a demon commander while your buds efficiently exercise the hell out of it? No one died? Happiness. The ability to voice chat before and during a match allows for strategic communication in both team creation and forming of tactics. Certain classes just work better with others, as do certain builds. The combo system allows for massive damage to be dealt when opportunities arise. If that's the case, why not plan for these opportunities? My mage friend is going to chain panic foes. I'm going to take the ability to always crit panic foes. It just makes sense. There are only 3 levels, but the levels are always randomized. The rooms are laid out differently, the foes are placed in different locations, the enemies come in 3 flavors, your group makes up changes, and the bonus challenges are randomized. So while matches can feel similar, they're never 100% identical. While I've mentioned a bunch of reasons I've been addicted to this multiplayer, the most important reason is it's simply fun. The desire to advance, get better randomized weapons, and to take on harder challenges is great and all. But in this game, the process doesn't feel grueling, so it's just enjoyable. This is a win-win, and it's the reason for my most recent illness. Now, I'll be right back. I gotta go promote my assassin. I didn't like where I put one skill point. Whoa, Thanksgiving's over?
What?
Fuck the demon commander.